In ancient China, male concubine is called a 面首. 面 represents the beautiful face, and 首 represents beautiful hair. This word is created by Princess Shan Yin in the Northern and Southern dynasties. Princess Shan Yin, Shan Yin Gongzhu, is called Liu Chu Yu. She is the four older sister of the Emperor Qian Fei. According to the historical records, one day, Princess Shan Yin tells Emperor Qian Fei that they are born to the same parents, but Emperor Qian Fei can have lots of imperial women. Well, she only has one husband. It is so unfair. Emperor Qian Fei thinks so. So he gives Princess Shan Yin 30 handsome young men as male concubines. Princess Shan Yin isn't the only female who has male concubines. Before the Song Dynasty, it isn't hard to accept that a powerful woman has male concubines, because before the Song Dynasty, high-rank female royal members have a chance to deeply influence political decisions. They had capabilities to give men money and political powers if those men can please them. In this video, I can tell you three famous stories about the powerful woman and her male concubines. The first lady is Xuan Taihou, Queen Dowager Xuan, who was known as Mi Bazi. Queen Dowager Xuan was the concubine of King Hui Wen of Qin and the biological mother of King Zhao Xiang of Qin. She was the first queen dowager in ancient Chinese history. In 306 BC, King Zhao Xiang inherited the throne. The king of Yiqu wanted to the capital of Qin state to attend Zhao Xiang's coronation. Queen Dowager Xuan met Yiqu king and had an affair with him. Queen Dowager Xuan had two boys with Yiqu king. Later, Zhao Xiang and Queen Dowager Xuan decided to conquer Yiqu. Queen Dowager Xuan tricked and killed Yiqu king. Queen Dowager Xuan's other male concubine was called Wei Chou Fu. When Queen Dowager Xuan was seriously sick, she required Wei Chou Fu to sacrifice for her. Wei Chou Fu was so scared and asked Yong Rui to help him. Yong Rui asked Queen Dowager Xuan that whether people had soul. Queen Dowager Xuan said no. Yong Rui said if people didn't have soul, Wei Chou Fu couldn't accompany Queen Dowager Xuan in the world after death. Then why kill Wei Chou Fu? If people had soul, King Hui Wen definitely was mad at King Dowager Xuan for a very long time. She had no chance to have Wei Chou Fu as male concubine anymore. Queen Dowager Xuan agreed with Yong Rui and didn't kill Wei Chou Fu. The second lady I want to mention is Guan Tao Gongzhu, Princess Guan Tao. She was the four older sister of Emperor Jing of Han and the mother-in-law of Emperor Wu of Han. When Guan Tao was about 50 years old, her husband passed away. Guan Tao falls in love with a young man called Dong Yan. When Dong Yan was 13 years old, he with his mother came to Guan Tao's resort to sell beads. Guan Tao was attracted by this beautiful boy and adopted him. Guan Tao gave Dong Yan the best living conditions. In return, Dong Yan became Guan Tao's male concubine. Later, almost everyone knew about their relationship. Dong Yan worried Emperor Wu was mad and punished him. So he suggested Guan Tao give Emperor Wu a resort as a gift to please the emperor. Guan Tao did, and the plan worked. Emperor Wu accepted their relationship. Dong Yan passed away at age 30. Several years later, Guan Tao passed away. In her will, he refused to be buried with her husband and asked Emperor Wu bury Dong Yan with her. The Emperor Wu did. The third lady is Wu Zetian, who was the only female emperor in ancient Chinese history. In 699, 9 years after Wu Zetian became the emperor, he created a department called Kong He Jian. All males belonged to Kong He Jian, or Wu Zetian's male concubines. Although Wu Zetian had lots of male concubines, only four of them were widely known by today's people. Xue Huaiyi was Wu Zetian's first male concubine. At the beginning, he was Princess Qianjin's male concubine. Princess Qianjin was the daughter of Tang Gaozu, but he voluntarily became Wu Zetian's foster daughter. To please Wu Zetian, Princess Qianjin gave Xue Huaiyi to Wu Zetian as a gift. Except please Wu Zetian on the bed, Xue Huaiyi did many contributions to Wu Zetian and got several noble titles. But with Wu Zetian had more and more male concubines, Xue Huaiyi lost Wu Zetian's favor. Xue Huaiyi was killed in 695. In future video, I will tell you Xue Huaiyi's stories. Wu Zetian's second famous male concubine was Sun Nanqiu, who was Wu Zetian's imperial doctor. In official historical documents, there were only a few records about him. Now, we only know after Wu Zetian had Sun Nanqiu as the male concubine, Xue Huaiyi was furious and burned a palace called Mingtang in 695. Zhang Zhongchang was Princess Taiping's male concubine. When Wu Zetian about 75 years old, Taiping gave Zhang Zhongchang to Wu Zetian as a gift. Zhang Zhongchang quickly got Wu Zetian's favor and introduced his older brother Zhang Yizhi to Wu Zetian as male concubine. Zhang brothers deeply involved in political battles and have a very bad ending. I will tell you Zhang brothers' stories in future videos. Thank you for watching this video. See you soon.